the last-ditch effort to save death row inmate Robert Roberson from lethal injection.
Chair Moody.
Present.
Vice Chair Cook.
Here.
An unexpected moment for a man who faced imminent death.
The role of government, ladies and gentlemen, is the protection of life.
A Texas House committee reconsidering the lawfulness of Robert Roberson's murder conviction. Though he was expected to appear, the committee announced he would not testify.
That doesn't mean Robert won't testify at all. In the spirit of cooperation, we are in talks with the Attorney General's office right now about ways their position can be addressed.
But called to testify, people who are firmly in Roberson's corner, including crime author John Grisham and Dr. Phil McGraw.
I am 100% convinced that we're facing a miscarriage of justice here.
What keeps me hopeful? My faith in the Lord and stuff, you know, because one day walking up out of here, you know.
Roberson has long been fighting from behind bars while on death row. Convicted based on a discredited shaken baby syndrome after taking his two-year-old daughter, Nikki Curtis, to a hospital when he found her unconscious in 2002.
So many people came together to stop Robert Roberson's execution.
The Innocence Project joining the legal fight for Roberson, who has autism, saying Nikki was suffering from pneumonia and was prescribed medication that likely caused her death.
If we had to take this same case to court today, there's no way in the world we'd get a conviction with a set of facts that we worked with.
The detective who helped jail Roberson testifying in front of the committee last week, legislators issuing an unusual subpoena to hear from Roberson, who was 90 minutes from execution.
He's an innocent man, and we're very close to killing him, something he did not do.
The action caused a legal tug of war between a Texas attorney general fighting to keep the execution in place and legislators trying to prevent it, with the Texas Supreme Court issuing a last-minute stay.
His impairment led to being misjudged. Outdated science has landed him on death row for something that wasn't even a crime.
And the legal maneuvers continue as Roberson's life hangs in the balance.